Karthik here. It's really very nice to see you all after a very long time. And for people who have watched few of my earlier videos would have noticed this tonsured look of mine. And it's nothing but a failed lockdown experiment. So I tried cutting my own hair and finally ended up like shaving the entire thing. So let's keep that aside. And we all know this is a lockdown period and people have been like working from home and there's a lot of negative news around us. And so these are situations where we are not used to these kind of situations, right? I mean, working from home for a longer period of time without being able to step out of home and roam as freely as we were roaming earlier. So these are not something that we are used to. These situations can be a little stressful, but not as stressful as it is being projected on the social media platforms. See, every now and then, whenever I browse, right, I mean, I stumble upon an article which talks a lot about coping up with stress because of working from home. I seriously don't understand what is so stressful when it comes to working from home, when it comes to like being around people whom you love the most and working from there. I don't know what is causing that stress. But that is when I realized, okay, why don't I make a video where I explain about the top 5 things that you can probably do in this lockdown period to enjoy this lockdown period and at the same time avoid, if so you go through a stressful period, how to overcome that. These 5 process or steps that I'm going to talk about now can help you overcome the stress, the little amount of stress that you have. I'm no saint to talk about or preach about the process, but still I felt these steps, since I've been following it for almost a month now, I felt okay, I thought of sharing it with you people and I have found it really helpful. So I thought I could transfer this knowledge to people, and if it's going to be of any help to you, and I'm going to be the most happiest person. So with that, I request you all to watch the entire video so that you get to know about all the things that I do. I'll share my personal experience and I'll share my points as well. So probably you can listen to that, watch the entire video, get some insights out of it, try implementing it in your personal life, and I'm sure you're not going to be disappointed. Come, let's jump into it. So the first and the foremost thing that everyone can do is to spend as much time as possible with your loved ones or your family members. So in my case, it's just me and my mother. So I ensure I spend a lot of time with her. I talk about everything that is possible. Okay, like the path that she has traveled. She's like almost married for like 35, 40 years. And I understand about what are the pains that she has gone through to bring me as a person to what I am today. And I share my experience, I mean, office going experience or like whatever I come across on social media platforms. So I keep sharing it with her. So only source of information for her is me. So I keep talking a lot with my mother. And to be very honest, I've understood a lot about my mother in this period. Yeah, I have never known that she is very much very expressive. Yeah, look, I've understood that she's very expressive and she has been sharing a lot of her likes and dislikes. I got to know more about my mother in this period. So likewise, it's just a matter of, I mean, it's just me and my mother in my case. Probably people around would have a lot of few other people as well. Like you would have your sisters, you would have your brothers with you, you would have your dad. I mean, you would have a lot of other people in your family. I mean, if there are more number of people, I think you have more time to like interact with them, understand them, and get to know about who they are, what their likes and dislikes are. Believe me, I have till 15 more days for the lockdown to end. We all have 15 more days for the lockdown to end. And I'm 100% sure that this time is not going to be enough to talk about things that my mother has gone through in her entire life, or share, or for her to share the experiences. So we have got enough topic to talk about. I mean, you won't believe, you literally think and be mesmerized about the fact that you had so much to talk about. So trust me, this was definitely going to be a lot of stress buster. This is definitely going to come in as a stress buster. Talk a lot, interact with them, and get to know more about them, understand them, and ensure that your bonding enhances and increases. actually do is to pick up a new hobby. So by new hobby, I literally mean it. So try exploring a new avenues and see how you can enhance your skills in that. So in my case, I'm not that technology person. I'm not that inclined towards technology related stuffs. So when the lockdown period started, a couple of my friends came and approached me and they asked if we could create a website and start posting technology related blogs on a daily basis. Initially, I was quite apprehensive to give them a nod right away, but I thought through it and decided, okay, I have to step out of my comfort zone and do something so that I can learn a lot of things. And hence, I gave them a nod at that point in time. And it's almost a week now since we have started posting a lot of articles related to technology on a daily basis. We've been doing it quite consistently as well. This is my case, okay? So even if you can do something of that sort, you can pick up a new hobby. It could be anything. It could be like you can pick up an instrument and learn about that, or you can you might not be good at cooking, you can try your hands with cooking, you can try your hands on painting, drawing, it can be anything. Pick up a new hobby and start working on it. So believe me, a month ago, if you had shared with me an article, a technology related article, and asked me to like go through it, I would have just ignored it. I wouldn't have bothered to open that link. But now, since I've started posting a lot of articles related to technology, what I've been doing is I've developed the patience to go through each and every article that I come across. I mean, I spend a lot of time to like go through each and every single article, and I think through how this can be articulated in such a way that people can understand it easily. So that's how I've been thinking. So that's how your thinking process is going to change once you pick up a hobby and start working on it. 10-15 days, start working on it, it's going to become a habit, and I'm pretty much sure that you're going to find it difficult to go back to those old days once you start mastering this. So what are you waiting for? Just go ahead, pick up a new hobby and start working on it. The third thing that you can actually do is to enroll yourself to an online course or attend as many events, seminars as possible. So there are a lot of free online courses that are being offered by different institutions these days. So you can enroll yourself to any one of those courses that interests you the most, and do it on a consistent basis. I mean, choose a course and like enroll yourself to that course and start doing it on a consistent basis. This is definitely going to enhance your skill sets and at the same time add a lot of value to your resume. This is one thing that you can actually do. And apart from this, if you're not that kind of a guy who is interested in doing an online course or taking up an online course, you can probably choose to attend a lot of online events happening. See, prior to a lockdown period, I'm that kind of a guy who actually ensures that I go and attend a lot of events that's happening across the city. So I get to meet a lot of people, I get to interact with the speakers. I mean, there are a lot of things that you can actually learn from an event. So since this lockdown started, everybody has started taking things online. A lot of events are being conducted online. And the beauty of taking things online is, prior to lockdown, even when you go and attend a live event, you wouldn't have access to all the events that happens in other cities. So now since things have started taking place online, you have access to events that happens across, not just across the city, also across the country. So that is a greatest advantage that I personally feel. So you get to meet a lot of people, you get to interact with a lot of people. Ensure that you don't attend random events or seminars. Attend events and seminars which you think would add value to your career. So attend those kind of events, contribute by pitching in with relevant and right questions. Okay, and these are tough times that we're actually going through, right? I mean, we hear a lot of news about layoffs and unemployment and all those things. So building this kind of a network by attending a lot of events and pitching in with the right mindset or pitching in with the right questions or contributing to those events can definitely help you a lot. If not right away, at least in the near future, it's going to help you a lot. So ensure you attend as many events as possible and ensure you pitch in with the right intent so that it's definitely going to come back to you in a good way sometime in the near future. point is build a brand for yourself and increase your social presence. So by brand, what do I mean here? Okay, by the end of this lockdown period, ensure that there's at least one or two person who you're not even acquainted to talks about your work. So that is a great achievement. If that is done, that's a great achievement. Okay, so ensure that you work towards that. Initially, I was talking about working or picking up a new hobby and working on that, right? Keep that going and parallelly work on things that you're already good at. Okay, there would be a lot of things that you're actually good at, and you would have started off with something and would have stopped it halfway through. Pick all those things, start working on it, enhance those things, and keep posting that on social media platforms. The reason why I am asking you to like post all these things on social media is when you do keep posting things on social media on a consistent basis, that itself will act as a motivation factor. Just for the sake of posting things on Facebook or posting things on Instagram, you would start working on it. You would ensure that you do it on a consistent basis and keep posting it. So that is really a good thing. And also, while posting things on social media platforms, ensure that you use the right hashtags, you tag the right people, and you tag the right community out there, community pages that you have out there. So this will enhance your social presence. So as I said, the ultimate goal at the end of this lockdown period, there should be at least a couple of people whom you're not acquainted to. They should talk about your work. Okay, looking at the work, they should have followed your work and they should talk about your work in a good way. So that should be your ultimate goal and work towards that. And I feel this is the right time to like build a brand for yourself. So building a brand is not a bad thing. Okay? Everybody wants to be known or renowned in this social circle. So it's always good to showcase things that you do the best and build that kind of a social presence. The last but not the least thing that I'm going to talk about now is take care of your physical and mental health. So with the current situation in place, there are too much of negative talks going around, and it's so easy for everyone to fall prey or to succumb to all those negative things happening around us. It's easy to be said than done, but ensure that you stay away from all those negativity and stay optimistic. A social media platform is one of the major platforms where all these negative talks, hatred is being spread. So I wouldn't say you should completely avoid using social media, because I also even spoke about building a social presence. So you definitely need social media as a platform at this point in time, but ensure that you don't consume too much of negative talks or consume too much of negative things. Okay, like ignore all those, when you read the first two words or first couple of lines, you would get an idea of what that post is all about. If you get a feel that that's going to be something negative, just ignore that post, skip that post, go read or consume things only that makes you happy, that keeps your mind fresh and happy. So consume only those kind of information, and that is going to definitely do wonders. See, as I told, this is easy to be said than done, but if you keep doing this on a consistent basis, keep ignoring, try ignoring all those posts or news that keeps coming in, negative news that keeps coming in. Keep ignoring them on a consistent basis, and by the end of like 10 to 15th day, you should be, I wouldn't say you should be a saint, but still, you should be a guy who knows how to train your mind. Like you would have already trained your mind in such a way that your mind knows what to read and what not to. So you should be in that level of, you should be in that stage. So ensure that you take care of your mental strength, and also do a bit of workout right from home to keep your physical health stable as well, right? You can do all these kind of skippings, ab crunches, push-ups, pull-ups, and all those things can be done right from your home to keep your physical health stable. And also you can do yoga if you're good at it, and meditation is also something good which keeps both your physical and mental health stable. So ensure you do something, you keep yourself occupied, you do something to take care of both your physical and mental health. Thank you.